always got to start with an introduction. Cheryl.
Hello.
Oh, what's that front light coming through there? Anyway, hi. Okay, so let's start. What are we starting with first?
We've joined the collar together and now we'll top stitch to one side on the edge.
Facing
up.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Yep.
So that's been fused as well.
Double fused.
Yes.
Let's
have a
yeah. Okay. So then we fold it over on itself. Quarter inch seam.
Yep.
So. The other end the same.
Mm-hmm.
We trim off the point.
So it's not bulky.
Yep.
So it's the collar edge point.
Right. Poke it in. Sorry,
that's my
filming. I pull out the points.
Mm-hmm.
Be very careful.
Using your scissors, is that careful?
Yeah. You can get it pointier than that. Or you can go
yes,
in
yeah,
that way.
I was going to say stick it inside.
No.
Point out.
Try not to come through the fabric. Right side, top side of collar, run a stay stitch on the edge.
So I don't know if I heard that.
Run a stay stitch on the edge.
Okay.
Now we put the collar stand on. Matching. This is double fused also.
So it's a pair main.
Yep. Yep. So we now sandwich the top collar, positioning to the nicks. Pinning in place. So nick in the center. Both sides. So now with a quarter inch seam, back stitch. Gently round the corner. Make sure it's all together. Line it up as you go. And keep it firm. It doesn't stretch. Okay, so this is the wrong side with the stitching, so you turn it to the right.
Oh, sorry, I'm stitching it here.
Just give it a little stitch right along.
Okay.
stitch around the collar base, mm-hmm. just to give it some strength and guideline when you turn it under. Here I have my yoke pattern, which is cut on the fold and double. So you've got a pair. Mm-hmm. So right side inside. Here is the back yoke, the back body, cut on the fold. So you open it up and you'll find two nicks, which we will gather up. Use a big stitch. Leave a thread at the end. You can repeat that if you want to make it stronger. Then we just pull it together and even it out. And get one of the yokes, the inside, to the right side of the fabric. Right side to right side. So you match up the nicks.
Right side to right side. Do you play with that gathering much?
No, just get it so that it fits equally. So we can stitch the back yoke
to the to the notch marks, mm-hmm. or nicks.
Put the other yoke on top, so sandwich it, turn it over, and you join it all together just below that row of stitching. Just making sure that you gathering is out of the way. Okay, so now we have
so we're looking at the right side now.
Right side of fabric.
Facing up.
So we have a row of chop stitching.
Okay.
our back yoke.
Beautiful.
Okay. So this is our front, which is cut on the fold, and this is our facing, which I have pre-made up to save time. So it's fused, overlocked, and the same, it's stitched down.
And then you would have, to pull those points out, would have
stitched it.
Used on each stitch, I think. Great.
So, with the front yoke,
take that over.
Right sides to right sides. Put your back yoke down. Stitch it across. Matching knits. Same with the other side.
I love how you just go right across to the other without stopping.
So now we've put them together, we get the back yoke. So we fold it over, grab the end, and then stitch it together, bag it out.
Looking at the back.
This is the back yoke. Yes. Double front joined together. So we twist it so that we bag it out. Make sure it's even. Just sew below that row of stitching and don't knit back stitch. Bagged out the yoke. So that's the right side.
Front and back.
Yep. Now we can repeat what we did. We twist it around.
Whoop.
So that we put the right sides together.
Yep.
Back stitch. Row of stitching, make sure it's straight. And voila!
Okay, let's pull it out.
We have a double yoke. So now, stitch up the top of the armhole.
Yes. The yoke to the shoulder.
The yoke to the shoulder. Pivot and you stitch across. And around the neck. Another shoulder and then down again. Finish.
Beautiful.
So we have our collar. This is okay. So this is our collar.
Mm-hmm.
You come from the wrong side,
Wrong side of what?
The garment, yep. To the centre back.
So wrong sides together.
Yep.
Yep.
Match up your nicks to the shoulder. I'll just trim that away. The front neck edge to there. And then we... Oh, I'm unthreaded, sorry.
That's right.
Tack it on if you want to, or pin it. Make sure you get that seam edge of the stand.
Yes.
So make sure the edge of the front sits flat with it. So. Now we'll start from this end, repeat that, same at that end, right where the join is. Might need to neaten it up a bit, get those hairs away.
Okay. Is that to reduce bulk?
Yeah.
And to be tidy.
Yes. Okay, let's go. Stand out of the way, then start very close back stitch, remove the pin, it's quite tricky.
Feeling. Are you stitching on that other stitch line?
Yes. Use that stitch line as a guide.
That's the centre front where you've started,
yes.
Right?
So up to the shoulder, remove the pin. And just ease it in a little. Is saying a curve onto straight. We've got the collar stand on, wrong side. This is the right side of the collar stand.
Okay.
So that folds like that.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
So to get a nice point,
yes.
Bag out the corner. It's quite a fiddly job. Just an inch or so.
Uh-huh.
And why just
to make the corner.
Okay.
Just follow that stitch line. Wiggle waggle.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Oh, so then you can do an edge stitch, are you?
Yeah.
Right.
So we do the same to the other end.
Okay, I'll just stop there.
Back on itself.
We will show you, just in case you didn't get it with the other side.
Tidy it up a bit.
Mm-hmm. Linen that's not gonna, in a finer fabric, it would sit flatter. So you've got this quarter of an inch stitch line. Oh, that's right, you did earlier.
Is that where you fold it under?
So that's your guide to fold under, okay.
Down so that you're not moving your collar around.
Mm-hmm. As you stop the time.
I'm showing you cover that stitch line. Go under.
That right round to the other side?
Yes.
Yep. Okay. Got that, making sure
they
mix.
Match.
And when you stop to tuck it under, put your needle down.
Okay.
Okay, so Cheryl's finished right to the other end. Now, what
you I've got the corner of the collar stand.
Stitching around.
Just top stitching the collar. Keep it firm.
Yep.
It's not the best collar stand.
beg your pardon?
It's not the best collar stand I've ever done. This is the easy bit. Now to the corner, just gently swivel it around, and we're back.
Oh yes. Okay.
Bit of fluff.
That out.
Yeah.
Okay, done. So, did you want to do the sleeve, one of the sleeves now?
Mm-hmm. Okay.
The elastic, is it?
Is that what you do?
Okay.
Then we fold it in half, whoop, right sides together.
Yes.
And join the side seams.
Okay. I might leave that bit actually, okay. Sorry.
I'll just go down.
Zoom down.
Okay. Here I have a pair of sleeves. I've already done one, stitched it up.
That's
join the elastic. Turn the sleeve under. So,
okay, yep.
Join that to there. Now, put your needle in and don't catch the elastic. Stretch the elastic out.
So, sorry, when you say don't catch it, is it just encased in there? So you push it right up
here? Yeah, so I'm just stretching it out. The elastic shrinks a little.
Okay.
And then we stitch on the edge.
Can you pre-shrink the elastic?
No, you can re-shrink it. I mean, you can shrink it back
mm-hmm.
when you iron it with the steam.
Yes.
Because it will stretch out a bit. So this is free.
Yes. Except
at the center back sleeve. Needle down,
yes,
so that it doesn't move.
Mm-hmm.
And there you go. Okay, so we have it all in one go. And then we can finish off the blouse.
Okay, great. So this is the other sleeve. This one. Cute.